Well, I'm very happy and humbled to meet this family, but first of all, let me get to know their names, starting with you. Hi, lady.
Hi.
What's your name?
Exactly, Doreen.
Doreen?
Yes.
Which course have you been pursuing?
Bachelor of Information Technology.
Information Technology. Okay, and this is your dad?
Yes, that's mine.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Yes.
What's your name?
My name is Fabi John.
Fabi John.
Yeah.
Okay, now, nice to meet you too. So now, today is 67th graduation ceremony. It's a very big day. By the way, how much are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Okay. Has that already given you something big?
Of course.
All right, now let me talk to your dad. Now, we're looking at the perspective of a parent. What does it take to raise a child to university to this point that she has graduated?
One thing I discovered as a parent is that it's very important to develop communication, to close the communication gap.
Yeah.
And more so with a girl child. That you are aware it's not very easy for a girl to start from nursery up to university without any incidents.
Exactly.
So I'm very proud of my daughter that we know we have been, as much as I'm a child, she's a child, I'm a parent, but it is very important that we put that communication flow. That if there's a challenge that side, I'm aware if I have a challenge.
Some parents are casting why they did what? They brought their children here at Makerere University. How about you? Did you make a good choice of a university?
Personally, I'm a product. I'm an alumni of this university. And I can assure you, I don't regret having been here.
Okay.
And I believe it is the best university so far. Even the rankings in Africa show the same. The product show the same. So I have no regrets.
Okay, I'm talking to more families here at the 67th graduation ceremony. I just invited another family from Tanzania. How are you, man?
I'm very okay.
Mambo VP?
Poa, poa.
Okay. Your parents, right?
Yeah, they're my parents.
What's the name?
Vivian.
Vivian.
Mr. Barnabas Langai is my son.
Okay, nice to meet you. Okay, now let me talk to him. Since you're from Tanzania, tell me, what is the experience studying in Uganda? How do you find it?
Okay, what I can say is I get more exposure when I'm here. There are a lot of things I learn that they are not happening the other side.
Sure.
So I like though sometimes face some challenges, but
okay.
I like the challenges and the exposure.
So Makerere University, do you think you made the best choice of the university?
Of course, exactly.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's talk about the course, by the way, you've been pursuing.
BCom, Bachelor of Commerce.
Bachelor of Commerce. So are you planning to take him back to Tanzania or is going to stay here?
We're going to Tanzania.
Sure.
Yes.
And you bring more children in Uganda or this one is the last one?
Yeah, he's already here. One, my daughter is here,
Is
Bridget. And then another guy is from 16 is here.
Who will stand against our king? No one cares. No one will. Oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him.
I'm Nyanze Victoria and I'm a recent graduate from Deje University with a bachelor's degree in business administration. I majored in marketing. I'm currently working as a public relations assistant for the Club Music Video Awards. It's a great honor to be on the show. I hope I'm going to enjoy it all. My lifestyle, I love to go out. I'm an outgoing person. I love dressing up. I so much love dressing up. I love taking care of myself, my hair, my body, and I have great passion and love for marketing, going out to people, talking to people, and that is all that I love so much, fashion and marketing and a little bit of hanging out. That's my life. You know, I'm motivated to do marketing and probably PR because I grew up with a strong love and passion to talk to people and then discovering new ideas. I also believe in branding, making yourself a brand or something that people have to look up to. And if you think about all those aspects, they just learn into something, but not only one thing but marketing. So I so much love going out to people and talking to them, and that is what really motivates me to do what I love doing. Apparently in Uganda, I don't look up to anybody, but I look up to a Kenyan woman called Caroline Motoko. She's an entrepreneur, she does so much of charity, but Her strong urge for business is what inspires me a lot. I really want to grow up and be somebody like passionate about business and career. Currently, I'm doing PR for the Club Music Video Awards, and it's one thing that I have all my energy and effort to, but with time, we shall have so much that I'll be working on. As a young female marketeer, there are too many challenges that I could be facing, because there are men out there that look at you and see it as an advantage for them. You're looking out for a job, you're fresh out of university. These people are like, oh, we just have to get something out of this girl. You know, there's just too much that is out there for you. Even if you're just given a product or you're doing marketing for any company or what, you approach somebody, you want to sell something to them, they also want to pitch an idea into your brain. It's really challenging, but just have to go over it like a diva. Best experience in school. I was this kind of student who comes to campus, takes their lecture and goes out to work. I'm so much motivated into working. I didn't have so much time to stay at campus or mingle around with students, so I really have not much to tell about campus. Worst experiences at campus, oh my God. You know, as any university student, you have so much that you want to put on yourself. You want nice hair, nice nails, everything. If your parents can't give you all that, sometimes you end up spending some of your tuition expecting to pay it back. So that is my worst, that was my worst experience. I spent some of my tuition, I had to hustle to have it back. But thank God, I did get it back. Balancing school and work, I'm this kind of person that tends to have a timetable, and the most universities, like my university in Deje, it has an evening program, day program, and weekend program. So I used to have my work schedules between 9 in the morning to 5 in the evening. And if you have a timetable, you know, you're following this, you want to get that money, but then you want to graduate. You can balance the two if you just have a timetable for everything you want to do. My type of guy, I prefer the ideal gentleman. Somebody tall, no fat, not small. You know, somebody, even in the dressing code, somebody has to have the A-class type of dressing code. I don't like people that do jeans so much. Just has to be gentle, the ideal gentleman. Just 3 tips for somebody to be a good marketeer or a PR for an organization. You need to make yourself a brand. Personally, you as yourself, just make sure you are a brand, because branding matters a lot. The second tip, you just have to have so many contacts in life. Anybody you meet, you think they're influential, even if they are not, pick their number and save their number, have their email address. Contacts matter a lot. And the third tip is just focusing on whatever you're doing. Just focus. Focus and determination. You will be good to go. Hey guys, it was nice having me on the show. Campus 101, Urban TV, MC Casmir, thank you so much. Youths out there, you're at campus, you know, you want to make it in life, just make sure you are determined and focused on whatever you're doing.
Okay guys, now today we're talking about some of the stories that's been trending. It's our graduation, but first of all, one thing that has been trending is the graduation. So Anita, how did you find the graduation generally?
It was good. I came early, obviously, and
I got a seat,
that's the main thing, and I was so happy and excited to celebrate with my friends graduation, the graduation day, and yeah, I hope for the best.
Okay, and how about your patience? Did your name even appear on the graduation list?
That was automatic, it had to appear. Oh,
yes! How can that be automatic? Everybody's gonna be on the graduation.
No, like you're sure of yourself, you know, I have to be there. Then I think it's the rain that distorted us a bit, yeah, it delayed the things, but the graduation was okay.
Okay, and Bob, how did you find the graduation?
It was really good, I enjoyed it. My name was on the list, I was read, people scrum my name. I loved it.
All right, now let's talk about, I was reading the tabloids and there is a story that's been trending that all of the students were scrapped off the graduation list. Have you guys heard about it, by the way?
Yes, I have, though I don't know more, a lot of in detail, but I have heard of it.
Now, they said that their results were altered. There were someone else's results, but they gave them to them. So after scrutinizing their results, it came out that they're not supposed to be on the graduation list. They didn't meet the requirements. And I'm wondering, if you guys were in that situation, Patience, what would you do?
I'm not certain, because the thing came out after, it was already due, the grad was coming. So I think you just wait and ask for...
Now imagine your parents are excited and then after three days to the graduation and they say that, oh, you're not going to be graduating. It is a mistake you being on the graduation list.
That would really depend. If I had involved myself in the malpractices, then I wouldn't be as much surprised as I would be in case I was straight and then found not on the list. I think I would definitely join the team and strike. What else?
Right, come on. So what would you tell your parents, in other words, in case that your name was among those 50 students?
Well, just like Fab, it really depends. Mm. If I worked hard for my marks and I'm not on the list, it would really hurt me, and I would also try to see that my voice is heard. Mm, sure. But if it was for the wrong reasons, then obviously I should face the truth and work hard.
Patience, give me a high five. Anita, thank you so much. Let's meet again. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the end of the show. Watch World of Fame. See you next weekend.
Keep it on the beat.